We're going to turn now to a developing headline we've been following all week here, the danger of exploding airbags in many cars across America, defective airbags. Authorities say they can deploy like an IED in your front seat. Tonight, at least two car makers suggesting you should get your airbag disabled. One car maker saying that you should keep passengers from the front seat. Here's ABC's David Curley.
It is a remarkable move by Toyota, telling nearly 250,000 consumers if it runs out of replacements, it will disable your airbag, and warning that motorists keep the passenger seat empty until a new bag is installed. Tonight, GM is going to send a similar letter. This after another 3 million cars, bringing the total to nearly 8 million, which should urgently have airbags replaced. That's the second correction of the numbers by the feds, who are telling drivers to go to their website to see if their car is affected, but the website isn't working. What's going on here?
That's the big question. NHTSA is the safety authority. They should get the message right. They should understand the facts.
The problem with the airbags is the inflator's explosive deployment. It can send metal shards flying. At least four deaths are linked to the airbags. Others have been injured.
I knew my ear was bleeding.
Angela Barbosa says her recall notice came after her 2012 accident near Dallas, in which shards injured her and cut up the bag.
Still makes me angry, just thinking about the people that are driving currently right now.
The airbags were made by the Japanese company Takata, and now 11 car makers are recalling and replacing those bags.
David, this is my car. It's on the recall list. For those 250,000 Toyota and GM vehicles, if they don't have a replacement, they're going to put a sticker right here on the passenger side that says, "Don't sit here until you get a new airbag."